Hey guys, this is Seaweed from Tribal Soup Project, and welcome to another episode of Creative Corner. Today we are obviously going to be doing a nail tutorial, and we're going to do some springtime flowers today. These are the polishes I am using. I am using this Sally Henson Nail Extreme Wear, and this is number 485 Golden Dash 1. I'm using this Spoiled Nail Color. Number S011, aka Tip Your Waitress. And I'm going to be using the Shani Nail Art Green, number 22. And as a top coat, I'm going to use the Sally Henson Double Duty Base and Top Coat. What makes these nail art polishes special is that they come with inside them a special nail art brush. It's a very thin brush that you can use to make nice lines. If you don't have access to this kind of polish, you can indeed make your own nail art brush by taking an old nail polish that you don't want anymore and using your nail clippers to cut down the polish and cut down the brush and make it a thin brush. And then the only other thing you will need in order to do this is a dotting tool. And as you can see, I just stuck a sewing pin and the eraser. There are other dotting tools that are specialized that you could buy for this, but I really like this one. I like how this one works a lot. So that's what I'm gonna use. So as you can see, I've already done one coat of my gold. And I'm going to go ahead and do my second coat now that it's dry. And I do want to stress the importance of letting your polish dry between coats. Because if you don't let it dry between coats, it's A, either going to take a really, really long time for it to dry, or else B, you might have some clumping issues. So it's a good idea to let the polish dry before you move on to the next thing. There are different kinds of nail art where you don't necessarily want your polish to be dry, but we're not doing that today. So we are going to make sure that our layers of polish are dry before we move on. So I'm going to go ahead and do the next coat of this gold, and then I'll let it dry, and then we'll start our nail art. Alright, so now that my second coat of polish is dry, I'm going to begin by using the green. And I'm only going to have flowers on. I'm going to have one on my ring finger and one, maybe two on my thumb. We'll see how it works out. Sometimes less is actually more. And then on the other fingers, I'm just going to have some kind of grassy looking wisps that come up. The key to doing this well is to not have a lot of polish on your brush. And what you can do is you can take a piece of paper and you open your polish up, and then you can just, you can let the polish actually run onto the paper like that and make a little dab. And then this is actually kind of cool because then you can run your brush back through the polish to reapply it as long as it's still very wet. So I'm going to start out by just making some grassy looking wisps. Going to make a couple lines that go up. Like that, and then maybe some short little lines to give it a little extra something. Just like that. Now I am going to have a flower on my ring finger, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make my stem, and that's going to be my longest wisp. Just like that, and it's a little bit thicker than the other wisp because, you know, it is a stem, so. And then I'll just continue making some little wisps along the outside, like that. And then I will just continue on for my other nails in the same fashion, and then I will let that dry. Alright, so now that my green is dry, I'm ready to do my flowers. And what you're going to do is you're going to take whatever color your flower is going to be, and you are going to make a dab of that color on a piece of paper. Just like so. And then you're going to take your dotting tool and dip it in the polish. And then you're going to make dots to form your petals. Is a good idea. You could usually do like two dots and then reapply the polish, but before you reapply the polish to your dotting tool, you want to kind of clean it off just a little bit, or else what happens is the polish builds up on there and it makes a very large dot. Just like that. And now, if you are very adept at this, if you're really good at it, you can put a little dot on the inside of another color to be like kind of the middle of your flower. But like I've said before, I'm kind of a novice at this, and sometimes less is more. So I'm just going to leave it like that. I think it looks pretty good like that. So, and now I'm going to do my thumb in the same way. Actually, I need to put another dab on the paper because this is starting to dry and you want it to be wet. You want it to be very wet, or else it'll be all yucky and clumpy. It'll be icky, yucky, and clumpy. Just like that. And now all that's left to do is for it to dry, and then we do our clear coat. Alright, so now that is dry, I'm going to go ahead and do my top coat. And then that will bring us to the conclusion of this video. I hope that you guys learned something. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to put them down into the comments below. If there's something in particular that you would like to learn, you can go ahead and suggest that also. I'm definitely open to any ideas. Please check out some of my other stuff that's linked down in the description. Subscribe to the channel, hit the like button if you like the video. And until next time, guys, create lots of cool stuff. See you guys later. Bye.